What's up, YouTube? It's me, Jefferson Chow, back at it again on Restaurant Critic. Today we got a special YouTube channel. I brought in a guest named Brittany Foote. She went with me to the restaurant called Screen Door to have her own aspect on what church is and what church is inside Screen Door. You guys are probably tired of always hearing my view and not hearing another person's view. It's always good to hear two different views and see if they collaborate or if they don't, because everyone has a different view on things. So we went to this restaurant called Screen Door. If you don't know where Screen Door is at, it's on East Burnside. It's not in the downtown area, it's more in the residential area. It's kind of like a Hawthorne, like a Alphabet district, like a Pearl district, where they go into the residential areas and they build businesses. And once again, East Burnside was a local business place. I say was because there are a lot of new businesses that are coming in that are commercialized, but they're now in the small aspect instead of a big aspect. Things have changed there. There's a lot of remodeling. A lot of local businesses have left the area. But overall, it's just a place that they're just trying to drag in the community to come and buy things. And just, I think their interpretation of trying to get a community is go where the community's at. So Screen Door is a local place. It's been there for a while. It's a Southern comfort place where they sell Southern food. To me personally, because I am not from the South, I don't really know what Southern food is. But I personally think they did a great job. It is a little fused, a little Portlandized, you know, but it is still Southern food. And I even brought Brittany because Brittany goes to the South a lot. So she said it is a little bit changed, but it is still Southern food in a way. So today, when you see Screen Door, I'm going to talk about Screen Door, talk about how Brittany sees Screen Door and how her view of Screen Door is as church. Besides that, the atmosphere was really loud. It was very vibrant. A lot of people were talking, and the music was so loud that when you were talking to the person across from you, it was hard to hear. But I also saw Screen Door as how we shepherd people. You know, church or not church, we are people who have friends, who have family, and sometimes it could be chaotic in how we deal with it. And someplace like Screen Door, where there's tons of people, it was packed, you know, it was vibrant, it was loud. Being loud is great because that means you're comfortable, you're being who you are. Playing music that doesn't annoy anybody but brings them to be relaxed and be able to be loud, that's always a plus. That means your atmosphere is great. But I noticed that the servers, how they were serving, you know, as leaders of a church, as leaders of anything that we do, we are all leaders somehow, and how we serve is really important. I mean, I've personally heard that from Arthur Kelly. If you don't know who Arthur Kelly is, he is a teacher from Warner, and he edited this book that says something about being a leader and a servant leader. And being the leader is someone who commands someone to do things, being, you know, organized and tell them to do this, do that. But being a servant leader is someone that does it with them, that does the task with them, and doesn't just tell them what to do, but does it with them and just leads them in action. And I saw that a lot at Screen Door. I saw that they were, even though there are so many people and there are so many things going on, there were diverse people in there, Asians, whites, blacks, Mexicans, all in there. But how the server handled the table was, she did a really good job. Even though she missed a few things, she did as much as she could without getting frustrated. She was aware and she was listening. I don't know how she was listening because it was loud in there, but she was still listening. That means she gave her undivided attention to us. She did miss Yvette. I also had Yvette come with me and David. She did miss Yvette's water when she was refilling water, but I don't think that was intentional. I think that was because she had a lot of tables to do. And sometimes as a church, we forget that there are so many people and we are always trying to please people and always trying to make sure everyone's okay, that sometimes we might miss people. And sometimes people, they might take it in a bad way or they take it in a good way. And what's funny is everyone's like, oh, did you see that? She forgot your water again. And she came like two or three times. But I saw that she was also trying to shepherd or take care of other tables. And as a leader, especially as a servant leader, it's hard to take care of everybody. That's why we need the community to back us up and to help the leader to take care of other people. And what's funny is, out of all that commotion, all that, Yvette said something to me that really got in my heart. Because no matter what, I think she saw the better side of the server, knowing that she was having a hard time, but she was trying. So we cashed out and we were paying and everyone was tipping. And usually I think I'm the best tipper in the world, you know, I tip at always 20%, if more. But Yvette, who had the bad service, tipped double of me. She tipped like 50%. And I asked, why did you do that? And she said, you always have to bless people. However you can, bless them. No matter what they do, bless them. And to me, that, even though that lady was trying her hardest, Yvette saw that. She wanted to bless her in a different way than whatever she could. And to me, I just took that as she was being a servant leader. That she created another servant leader to serve. Now, Brittany has another view of how she saw Screen Door.
Screen Door is a really great restaurant. It was big, spacious, very warm and welcoming, and also warm as in it was hot, but it was okay because it was cold outside that day. It was packed, and it reminds me of church in that it was very diverse. There were people of all sorts of different races, being that it was a southern-based restaurant. The waitresses and the waiters were very warm and welcoming. But on the other hand, there's a not so good aspect of it where a friend of ours who was sitting next to me in the corner, whenever the waitress would come by and pour water, she would like skip her cup. And it was probably unintentionally, but it happened nonetheless. And that could also be an aspect of church where people are often overlooked, whether intentionally or otherwise. And it happens and it makes people feel a certain way. It was her birthday that day also. And she wasn't really feeling too happy about being overlooked on that day, but that's something that also happens in church. And I guess in that way, Screen Door is like the church in good ways and bad ways. But overall, it was a really great restaurant. It was very reflective of the kingdom of God and diversity.
So, yeah. So I asked Brittany what church was to her.
Think much about the complexity of the church. I think it is something that's way more simple than most believe it is. It's the people, not the building. And so going to Screen Door with a giant building and a lot of people in it, it kind of felt like the church because it was packed and people were more focused on community as opposed to just eating at some fancy restaurant because it was super nice and hipster inside.
All right, so there's the different views that you see church and how I see church in the restaurant, how Brittany sees church in the restaurant. I hope it changes your view on how you see things out in the world, and not just framed on just church is church, that church is everywhere, church is a community, and church is love. Until next week, guys. Peace.